I'm not going to lie to you. This is the second time I'm making this video. So 3 days back, I had recorded this same video. At that time when I recorded it, I recorded the first half with my phone. Now this is the thing which I usually record my things on, before I got this camera. So what happened was that I recorded the first half to show you the physical device itself, and I recorded the second half with this camera so that you could make out the difference. So what happened on the day one was that the files from this phone were not transferring onto my laptop. Now don't tell me that you could have used the cable, you could have used this, you could have used that. I literally tried every single thing. I had uploaded the files from my phone to the Google Drive, and the next day I got up, I downloaded from Google Drive onto my laptop. The second day what happened was that the software, after I had downloaded these files, did not work, which made me sit in front of the laptop for 7 hours straight. The same night, the software fortunately started working somehow. The third day, the files were ready, the software was ready, but the files wouldn't transfer into the editing software. This made me sure that nothing was working, and it made the process very much hard. The fourth day, I realized I'm wasting too much time on this and thought to reshoot the video completely with the new camera. Hey, what's poppin', everybody? It's your boy Zakhan here, and I'm back again with another video. So I haven't made a video for a very long time, and what better time to make a video when I've got a new camera? And what better time to make a video? What better chance to make a new video about my new equipment? Now I know this video is going to be a little different from my previous videos and vlogs. This is going to be about my new equipment. So this is my new camera on what I'm filming right now. It is the Sony Alpha 6400, or you want to call it the A6400 or the A6400. The A stands for Alpha. So basically this is what this camera is. Now Sony releases 3 lines of camera. One is the APS-C line, one is the full frame line, and one is the more higher end full frame line. If you want to know what's the difference between full frame and APS-C, you can check that. If you want to know the difference between full frame and APS-C, you can check that out yourself on YouTube. There are literally millions of videos about that. Now coming on to this camera, is the A6400. This camera about released, maybe it went on sale 15 to 20 days back. So it's a brand new, it's the latest model that what Sony has released. So it's not about having the latest gear. I did not have any gear, that's why I went for the latest gear. So I was tired with my previous gear. I just used to use my mobile phone with this, and I used to face many more problems while filming with this. Number one problem being the storage. My iPhone storage always used to get full when I used to record maybe 2 videos a day, maybe 3 videos a day, or maybe even 1 vlog. Second thing which I was tired for, the battery used to die really quickly, and then I couldn't use my phone throughout the day. If I was done recording 2 videos or something, the phone would be completely dead and I had to reach home with no charge in the phone. So that was one big issue that I was facing. The third thing which used to bother me was the video quality. But keep in mind guys, I'm upgrading to this camera after maybe 1 and 1.5 years of filming with my phone. I had a long journey of how I started filmmaking, from when I started making videos, not even filmmaking, from when I started making videos. I had made videos on so many things. Like, I would not recommend anyone who is starting out YouTube to buy an expensive camera or expensive gear right now. Though it might not be expensive for you, but I feel it's going to be a waste of money. It'll be lying around your home, because talking and recording yourself in front of a camera is not a very comfortable thing for everyone to do. So you don't need a camera, you need a story. This right here is the Sony A6400 with the 18-135mm lens. Now what do I mean by 18-135mm? Whenever you see these numbers on a lens, don't get confused. It's just basically the distance of how far, what is the minimum zoom range of this lens and what's the maximum zoom range. So basically this is 18mm and then this is 135mm. This model I guess comes out for 5,200-5,300 dirhams. So this equipment right now which I'm using is for 5,200-5,300. If you're getting this in the United States, I guess it's a little more cheaper. Yeah, and if you're buying it in India, it's almost the same price. So you can get a cheaper version of this camera, the same camera with a smaller lens, as a 16mm to the 50mm. It's called 1650. So the 1650 will cost you around 4,100 dirhams in Dubai. If you want to upgrade to something, maybe then you can look ahead, but I would still not recommend you to go with this camera because I have got it. If you want, I can make another video which camera might be good for you, explaining the different brands and what they have to offer you. I can make another video because I've done a lot of research. So again, coming back to this one. So what a content creator generally requires from his camera. The first thing that a content creator requires is good image quality. The second thing that a content creator requires is 120 frames per second, or to easy it down, simplifying it, slow motion. So this camera provides slow motion as well at 120 frames per second. The third thing what a content creator requires is time-lapse feature. Now what do you mean by time-lapse is the fast moving videos, the classic fast moving videos, which I guess Casey Neistat or whatever you want to call him, sorry, began with, I guess, in his vlogs. The intro of his vlogs is always a time lapse. So yeah, that's that. So the reason why I got this camera is I took a long time to decide on which camera that I wanted. This camera is fulfilling all my needs, and as beginning out with the professional equipment, I guess this camera will cater to all my needs. So the first reason why I bought this camera is the image quality. This camera has a 24 point something megapixel CMOS sensor, which is the same sensor which is used in the higher model, the A7 series, the A7 Mark III, which is a 3,500 dirham more expensive camera that comes around 8,500, I guess. So that camera is more expensive than this, but it has the same sensor. And the image quality can be almost comparable or almost matchable if you swap lenses or if you get a faster lens. So the second reason why I got this camera is the amazing flip up screen. So right now I have a flip up screen, and there are so many high end cameras that these camera makers make, but they do not provide a flip up screen. Now when an individual content creator wants to record himself, he wants to know how is he in focus, is he in how is he in frame, and what's the focus, what is it focusing at and stuff. So this camera luckily provides a flip up screen, which is not a flip out, but it flips upwards. So this is the camera. I can flip the screen on top and I can look at myself through this, while there are Canon cameras that provide a flip out screen that flips out like this. This thing is not working. So number three why I like this camera is the autofocusing. Now the autofocusing on this camera is really crazy. So right now when I'm filming myself, and even if I'm filming with the screen flipped back on its normal place and I cannot see myself, I can trust this camera on a video recording mode to track my screen, so track my face, so wherever I move on, it's not going to lose the focus, and I can tap on somewhere else for it to focus over there. So right now it's focusing at the back, and if I want it, I can focus it back on my face. So this focus tracking keeps on continuing, and even if I keep hand on my face and if I remove it, it's still gonna track. The fourth reason why I got this camera is the 120 frames per second for the smooth cinematic B-roll shots. Moving on to the sixth feature, when I record through 4K, right now I'm recording in full HD, so it's not even 4K. This camera can do 4K, but then when you record in 4K, it does not record in 4K. Let me explain. It records in 6K and it downgrades the footage to 4K. So basically your 4K footage is really crisp, while as other cameras just record in 4K and you get the image in 4K. But this records in 6K, which downgrades to 4K. So the entire clarity is getting much more better. You get a more clear and crisp image. The seventh reason why I like this camera is because the mount. This has an E-mount lens, which is the same lens that is used in the more expensive model. So if I buy lenses for this right now, I can use the same lenses on higher cameras. But whereas Canon does not permit you to do that. If you're buying mirrorless cameras, that's almost the same range of these cameras, you have to buy completely separate lenses for those cameras, and they cannot be used on the bigger DSLR cameras. The eighth reason is the price, why I got this camera. So in this price range, I guess this camera was providing a lot of features that the other cameras were not providing. Ninth reason why I got this camera is the size of the camera. For some people, having a bigger camera might be a good thing, and for some people, having a smaller camera might be a good thing. But let me tell you, having a bigger or a smaller camera is only going to help you in short term for you to make you feel better that, you know, I have a bigger camera, so it's more powerful. The most important thing is that you need to know how to use your device, and this size of the device is going to help me carry around this device everywhere. It's going to help me make more vlogs. If I would have a more bigger setup, I think I wouldn't even take out the camera anywhere because of its size and its difficulty to carry around. Though this is going to be another challenge for me to carry around this camera compared to my phone. My phone will just slide into my pocket, but everything comes with a downside. So just making a 10th reason so that you people don't get an OCD along with me. The 10th reason is that the microphone is placed in the front over here and not at the top. The advantage of that is that when I'm talking, the audio directly goes and hits the mic instead of any unnecessary wind noise that passes on the top. Now everything comes with its own downside. The things that I don't like about this camera is the battery life. The battery life is not so great. I do need to pick up a second additional battery. The second thing that I do not like about this camera, if you attach an additional microphone on the top of the camera, that's going to fall somewhere here. Okay, so it's going to block basically my view. It's going to fall somewhere behind the camera and it's going to block my view of these. The third disadvantage that I feel this camera has are the lenses. The Sony lenses are very, very expensive if you want to get a Sony lens. Now, the lens right now which I'm using, if you want to get a separate edition for this, it comes up to 2,500 dirhams. So, you know, the lenses are really expensive for these cameras. So please guys, as you know, lenses are very expensive. So share my videos to your friends, to your family. And let my AdSense work and let me make some money through YouTube. Just kidding guys, just joking. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to share this with your friends, your family, and your friends who are looking forward to start a YouTube channel. And one more thing guys, if you are looking forward to start a YouTube channel, or maybe your friend is looking forward to start a YouTube channel, don't forget to mention in the comment section for me to make another video, or you can message me privately on Instagram and I'll come to know that if you people want a tips on how to start a YouTube channel and which equipment is the best for you to start, I can suggest you with the tips on starting a YouTube channel, coming up with names, or using the best editing software. What I have done personally, I can make a video for you people as I have known all these softwares and these equipment from a long time. So if you guys want help with any of those things, don't forget to drop a comment below, or if you're shy to drop a comment, you can just go and message me directly on Instagram. It's completely fine. So as always guys, stay kind, stay polite, stay humble, and stay cool.